Collagen is the substance that basically holds your entire body together. Let's face it, it's the most abundant protein in the human body. It acts as a building block for your bones, your teeth, muscles, skin, joints, connective tissues. In fact, types 1 and 3 collagen make up 90% of our hair, skin, and nails. And unfortunately, as time goes on, your body produces less collagen. Starting in your 20s, for example, you slowly start losing collagen, roughly 1% every year. So to make sure you support collagen growth in the body, you can take in high collagen supporting foods, and there are three in particular that are essential, which you definitely need to be aware of. I'll also be sharing with you one food that I think is a game changer when it comes to supporting collagen, so you don't want to miss this. Stay tuned till the end. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as be in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I would love for you all to gently tap on that like button down below. And if you really like the content, then I'd love for you all to subscribe as well. Now, without further ado, let's get straight into it. Now, if you haven't already watched the video I made on how to boost collagen for glass skin, I highly recommend you watch that one after this video. But a good place to start for this one is by asking the question, where does collagen come from? Well, it turns out your body can actually naturally make collagen, and it does this by combining amino acids that are found in protein with vitamin C, zinc, and copper. So to help your body produce collagen, you need a combination of foods high in these three key nutrients as well. What were they? Vitamin C, zinc, and copper. And you really can't start a conversation about collagen without mentioning these. So before I begin the list for collagen, let's take a look at the foods highest in vitamin C and how that ties back into collagen formation. Vitamin C is known as the collagen builder, which is why it's often used so much in skincare. And the highest sources of vitamin C are found in the red bell pepper, as one large pepper can contain over 200 milligrams of vitamin C. Keep in mind that studies have shown that absorption of vitamin C decreases to less than 50% when taking amounts greater than 1,000 milligrams. In generally healthy adults, megadoses of vitamin C are not toxic because once the body's tissues become saturated with vitamin C, absorption decreases and any excess amount will be excreted in the urine. However, you don't want to exceed more than 2,000 milligrams as this is the upper limit. Secondly, you have the zinc. And why zinc matters is because zinc is a cofactor in the production of collagen. It plays a vital role in collagen synthesis. It is essential to cell repair and helps protect collagen in the body from damage. And one of the highest sources of zinc is found in 1 cup of wheat germ, giving you 14 milligrams. And the recommended amount is 11 milligrams a day for men and 8 milligrams a day for women. And you shouldn't exceed the upper limit for zinc, which sits around 40 milligrams daily for both men and women. And lastly, we have copper. And the reason we need copper for collagen is because it activates an enzyme called lysyl oxidase. And what that does is cross-link the collagen fibers with any other supportive fibers, helping to form a stronger tissue network. And some of the highest sources of copper actually come from oysters at 3.8 milligrams, which is over 4 times the daily required amount needed, which you only actually need 0.9 milligrams a day and not to exceed 10 milligrams a day as the upper limit. Now that we got vitamin C, zinc, and copper out of the way, as well as the types of foods that contain the highest amounts and the required daily intakes of them, what about collagen supplements? You see, this is still a relatively new area of research, and many experts debate whether they even work or not. The one study that stands out comes from a 2014 double-blind study published in the journal Skin Pharmacology and Physiology. This study found that women who consumed extra collagen had higher levels of skin elasticity after 4 weeks than those who took a placebo. So I guess results vary, and I do see the arguments on both sides. And if you want to try one yourself to see how it works on your skin, then I left the best collagen boosting supplement I found that you could try down in the description below. Let's go ahead and talk about that one food I told you I'd share with you at the end, and that is ginseng. Panax ginseng is widely used in urban Asian countries, having anti-inflammatory, antioxidant, anti-tumor promoting, and anti-aging potential. There are several types of ginseng depending on the processing methods, including fresh ginseng, white ginseng, and red ginseng. And what is interesting is the research being done on how it could actually support collagen synthesis, as it has been demonstrated that 10 micrograms per milliliter of red ginseng extract increases the collagen synthesis and inhibits the MMP1 activity in human dermal fibroblasts, which MMPs are basically your matrix metalloproteinases, which break down collagen. So if ginseng is able to somehow slow that process down and stop it, it could play an interesting role in supporting collagen strength over time. Even though I would like more research to back this up, I think it's too early to give a full recommendation on red ginseng, but I do like the direction it's headed. Click the red subscribe button down below, and I'll see you guys on the next one.